Good morning. Welcome to St. John Lutheran Church and Christian Preschool. I'm so glad we could be here together on this beautiful spring morning today. It's so beautiful. We're going to have our social time outside today after worship. So we invite you to stop and have a cup of coffee and catch up with each other. Welcome. I'm glad we could be together. Thank you to Dale and Helen Bond for sponsoring our flowers today in honor of their 55th wedding anniversary. Congratulations, Dale and Helen. Yep. And thank you to Susan Shanklin for sponsoring our radio broadcast today on KCHA in memory of Steve Shanklin. So, where does a 400-pound bell sit? Anywhere it wants to. Right now, it's sitting in a storage room in our basement. On this 100th anniversary year of this building, we'd like to know more about that bell because we're not really sure for sure where it came from, how it got there, what its deal is. So if you know anything about the bell in our basement, please let Janet Pettifish know or me. We'd love to get that information. I would like to invite intern Beth forward.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning. I am super excited to get to announce that we will be having Vacation Bible School June 10th through June 13th. And just to add to the excitement, our shark friend is here with us today. VBS will run from 5:30 to 8 o'clock for kindergarten through sixth grade, and for four-year-old preschool, they will have a modified schedule and leave at 7:30. There is a QR code, so you can scan.
Hey, turn and look at your neighbors. You're not just here in worship to look at the screen. We're here together. Well, we begin this service in the name of our God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. I invite you to stand as we sing our gathering hymn number 393, a hymn of glory, let us sing.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, praise.
Well, it's still Easter, even though we're a couple of weeks out from Easter. It's still the Easter season. This is the third Sunday of Easter, and the kids are keeping us in mind of Easter and reminding us of that every week. Emerson gave us this great drawing. He is risen, Jesus coming out of the tomb, and Kenley drew the cross with the rainbow of God's promise of love that never ends. Laura drew a picture of the church. Jesus is with us, and even included the Good Shepherd window in her drawing. Wow, good job, Laura. And the Mars have a joke. Knock, knock. Who's there? Jesus. Jesus who? Jesus has risen. Yeah. Let's do that together, shall we? We'll do it responsively. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Jesus.
Jesus who?
Jesus has risen.
Yeah.
All right. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit is with you all.
And also with you.
Let's pray together the prayer of the day. Holy and righteous God, you are the author of life, and you adopt us to be your children. Fill us with your words of life, that we may live as witnesses to the resurrection of yours.
Thank you. Our reading this morning is 1 John chapter 3, verses 1 to 7. Him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we will be has not yet been revealed. What we do know is this. When he is revealed, we will be like him, for we will see him as he is. And all who have this hope in him purify themselves, just as he is pure. Everyone who commits sin is guilty of lawlessness. Sin is lawlessness. You know that he was revealed to take away sins, and in him there is no sin. No one who abides in him sins. No one who sins has either seen him or known him. Little children, let no one deceive you. Everyone who does what is right is righteous, just as he is righteous. This is the reading for the day.
I'd like to invite the kids to come up for the children's sermon, and as they come, let's sing Jesus Loves Me.
Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones to him belong, they are weak, but he is strong. Yes, Jesus loves me, yes, Jesus loves me. Jesus loves me, the Bible tells me so.
Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you guys today?
Good.
Good. Doing good? Good. Glad to hear it. So, can anyone tell me what that is?
A ghost.
A ghost. Bless you. Okay. So, what can ghosts do?
They're invisible and they sneak up on you and scare you.
Okay.
Haunt you.
Okay.
They can go through anything.
Yep.
Suck out your soul.
Oh. That took a dark turn. Okay.
They can't do anything. They're not real.
Okay. They can't do anything for real. Okay.
Fly through walls.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Follow you around.
Okay.
They're not real.
Oh, okay. Not real.
Fly through people.
Okay. Anybody else?
They can go at Halloween night and scare people.
Uh-huh.
And die in water.
Okay, in water.
They go through you and take your blood out.
Take your blood out. Okay. Ooh. Scary.
Be in fictional stories.
Be in fictional stories. Okay. He's making a point there. Okay. So what can't ghosts do?
Live again.
Ooh.
Eat food.
Okay.
Eat chicken nuggets.
More specifically.
Not suck out your soul.
Not suck out your soul. Yeah. He's sticking with it.
Not do anything.
Okay. Not do anything.
Can't pick up stuff.
Can't pick up stuff?
They can't try to push a cup over.
True. Okay.
They can't what?
They can't talk.
Okay.
They can't be normal again.
Okay.
They can't wear clothes.
Oh, right.
They can't touch people and they can feel you.
Okay.
And die in water.
Same. You said that before.
I know.
Okay. You're sticking with it. You don't. Okay. All right. So, there's a lot of things that ghosts can't do. And the reason why they can't do it is because they don't have a body. Right? Because they're ghosts don't have a body. So, in our gospel reading today, Jesus, he's just risen from the dead, and he goes to see his disciples, and they're afraid because they think he's a ghost, right? Because he came back from the dead, they think he's not really real, he's a ghost. And so Jesus proved to them that he was a ghost. How do you think he proved to them he was a ghost? He said, look at my hands. See, I have hands. I can pick things up. I can knock things over, right? And he said, hear my voice. I'm speaking to you. And he said, you got anything to eat here? And so they brought him some fish. And he ate fish to prove to them that he wasn't a ghost, that he had a body. Do you think there are any ghosts out here?
Yes.
You think so? You don't sound like, you know what? I need your help today. I need your help. We need to go and check and see if there are any ghosts out here today. Okay? All right. So here's what we're going to do. I'm going to give all of you these noisy buckets. Okay? Because today we're doing our noisy bucket offering for the youth mission trip. And so I want you to go out and I need you to check everybody. Okay? And everybody either needs to put money into the bucket or rattle the bucket to prove that they're not a ghost, okay? And when you're done, you have to make sure you get to everybody, okay? Everybody. And when you're done, bring your bucket up to me at the altar, okay? And then we'll put it on the altar and then sit down again. All right. You may have to share buckets. You may have to share buckets. Okay. Whoops, sorry. There you go. You know what? Just take one. Make sure you check everybody. Some of you may have to share. There you go.
Don't you know each cloud?
There you go. There's one for you. There's one for you. There's one for you.
You'll find your fortune falling all over town.
There's one for you.
There's one for you.
Make sure you check everybody. Either got to put something in or rattle it.
Macaroni. If you want the thing you love, you must have a pizza, holy baby.
Don't forget the, you got the balcony.
Don't run under a tree. Hail the pennies from heaven for you and me. Now come over here, boy, Sam. And every time it rains, it rains. And don't you know it's crocodile?
Raise your hand if you haven't been checked yet. Raise your hand.
You find your fortune falling.
Okay, bring it on up.
All over town, all over town, all over town.
Thank you.
Be sure that your umbrella.
Okay, have a seat. When you're done, have a seat. Giles, come back. Have a seat on the step. Wow, yours is really full. Thank you. Have a seat. Thank you. Have a seat. Have a seat. Okay. All right. All right. Wow, look at that. That's great. Have a seat. Look at that. Wow. Hey, wow, that's wonderful. Good job. Hey. Okay. Woo. Thank you.
And you'll find your fortune falling.
All right. Have a seat.
Wow.
Wow, look at that.
Panties from heaven.
Look at that.
For you and me.
Woo! All right. You guys did a good job. You got lots of money for the mission trip. Thank you very much. So you checked everybody, right?
Yeah.
Okay, my question is, how do I know that you guys aren't ghosts? I think you're going to have to prove it to me by eating fish. Goldfish crackers. All right. So wait, and you can get them after we say the prayer. Everybody, let's bow our heads, fold our hands, repeat after me. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
For not being a ghost.
For not being a ghost.
And really, really coming back from the dead.
And really, really coming back from the dead.
Amen.
Amen.
Okay, go see Owen and Molly, and they'll give you your fish to eat. And while they're doing that, let's stand for the gospel song. The Holy Gospel according to Luke, the 24th chapter.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus himself stood among the disciples and said to them, "Peace be with you." They were startled and terrified and thought that they were seeing a ghost. He said to them, "Why are you frightened? And why do doubts arise in your hearts? Look at my hands and my feet. See that it is I myself. Touch me and see, for a ghost does not have flesh and bones as you see that I have." And then when he had said this, he showed them his hands and his feet. While in their joy they were disbelieving and still wondering, he said to them, "Have you anything here to eat?" They gave him a piece of broiled fish, and he took it and ate it in their presence. Then he said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses, the prophets, and the Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures, and he said to them, "Thus it is written that the Messiah is to suffer and to rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance and forgiveness of sins is to be proclaimed in his name to all nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are my witnesses of these things." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
And you may be seated. Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed.
Alleluia. So what? So what? We're celebrating the season of Easter that he is risen. But what difference does that make? What difference does it make that Christ is risen? It doesn't fix all of our problems, that's for sure. In fact, for Jesus' disciples, it led to more problems for them. Now, there's a persistent idea that started right after Jesus' empty tomb was discovered. And is still being spread today, actually. And that idea is this, that the resurrection was a hoax. It was a hoax played on the world by the disciples. But that doesn't make any sense.
Are we all here? I need 100% participation for this to work.
Yeah, everyone's here. All 12. 11. 11 of us. Well, what's the plan?
Well, as you know, Jesus is dead. But stick with me, okay? Stick with me. I have a plan. We are going to steal his body.
Okay, I'm tracking with you. What's next?
And then we're going to tell the whole world that he rose from the dead.
Oh, you know I'm in.
I love it already.
All right, classic. Then what?
And then we're all going to get brutally murdered.
Oh! Wait, come again.
Could you go over that last part real quick?
Oh, what? We get murdered. What's the problem?
I like it. I like it. I mean, don't get me wrong, Pete. I love me a good hoax as much as the next guy, right? Right? What's in it for us? Do we all get riches, fame, and fortune first, right?
No, get this. You're going to be hated, persecuted, and reviled for the rest of your life!
Oh! Okay, guys. Okay, fellas. I gotta be missing something here, right? Okay? I mean, why on earth would we do this? Can we start over?
Oh, okay. We'll start from the beginning. Everybody, for John.
Yeah. The beloved disciple.
So, okay. We go down to Jesus' tomb.
Sounds good.
This is really easy.
Then we pay off the Roman soldiers that are guarding the tomb with their lives.
Why would
they do that, eh?
We somehow roll away the big stone that's in front of the tomb.
Obviously, you have to move the rock first. Duh.
And then we steal his body.
Yeah, I guess.
Then we tell the whole world that he rose from the dead, and we get brutally murdered for our troubles!
Epic prank, bro.
Peter, you rock! Okay, guys, okay, and then what?
Then we all get killed. Come on.
When do we see ourselves become exalted and praised?
That's just it.
You don't! What is happening? Anyone hear what I'm saying? This is the most idiotic plan of all time!
Chill out, bro. I mean, do I really have to explain the joke to you? Look, it's that we lie about Jesus' resurrection, and then we all die.
How am I supposed to chill out when our heads are getting cut off? Or worse, what is wrong with you guys? Thomas! Okay, look, back me up here. I know you can't be cool with all this. I know you gotta have some doubts. Come on.
Doubts? Ellen Nova, how did it do?
Okay, you guys have officially lost it, okay? I'm out of here. I'd rather be exiled to a deserted island than spend another minute with you wackos.
Have I got some good news for you?
Tradition says that John was exiled to a deserted island named Patmos. It doesn't make any sense that they would do that. And I want to be clear, because I know that kids don't get satire. They didn't really steal Jesus's body, right? It's made up. Even though some people think they did, the disciples really didn't steal the body. But spreading the good news of Jesus's resurrection really didn't make life easier for the disciples. It actually made life much, much harder for them. Would a prank really have motivated them that much? Would the disciples have endured so much hardship and been willing to give up their lives for something that they knew ultimately was a lie? Doesn't seem likely. In our gospel reading today, the disciples are doing the opposite of that. They're not plotting to steal a body. They're actually experiencing the living Jesus, whose resurrection showed that God's more powerful than sin and death, whose resurrection showed that everything Jesus taught was true, whose resurrection showed, as John wrote, that we truly are loved by the Father. We truly are children of God. Knowing that Jesus is truly alive, that we're truly loved and called to love others, allows us to do difficult things, because we know that nothing, not even problems or death, can separate us from God. Believing that Jesus is risen doesn't necessarily make our lives easier, but it does make them better.
Just one block east of downtown Los Angeles is one of the most dangerous, overlooked, marginalized places in the United States of America, and that's Skid Row. Skid Row is a place where horrible things happen all the time. Women and children are the most vulnerable to the crimes, but you also have gang members and drug dealers who sell drugs near rescue missions and hinder efforts to help people in the area. This is where I work. This is where God called me to be. And I believe that with my whole heart. You know, the reality here is most people don't really like police officers. They're taught to hate us because they feel we're after them because of their social status or a race or whatever. It's really hard to meet somebody you really want to help and have them reject you. Some of them hate my guts. And I really, truly, honestly care about them. Well, I try to look at people the way I think God looks at people. And in spite of all our mistakes, God still loves us. So in spite of all the mistakes that a lot of the people in Skid Row have made, I want to show them that I love them and I want to help make their lives better. You got to get out of your car sometimes, remove your judgmental idea about who people are and what a good person should be, you know, and get out there and get to know these people, because you'll find that even though some of them have a lot of problems, severe problems, mild problems, they're people.
Let me feel it.
There you go, that's it. That's the real deal right there. We'll get you there.
All right. Dion Joseph, call me Dion.
They're told the police hate you, but I destroy that theory when I get out in that street, because those folks will test you. If you say you care, they're gonna hold you up to it. Okay, Joseph, you care? Put me in some housing.
The Dion?
Okay. Yes,
oh,
Dion.
For real?
Yeah, if you're interested in some 90-day housing?
Yes, yes.
Okay, what I want you to do is Thursday. Go see my friend, she's a wonderful lady. Over time, the people see you for who you are, not what you are. They know I'm doing what I'm doing, not to harass them, but because I'm for them. All right?
We'll do both.
All right, ladies, take care.
All right, thank you.
Hey, how are you? You know, you're a star. How you doing?
Because you love this kid, Ralphie.
I do. Get to know people on an individual basis. I know their names. I know when they've been sober. I know when they're high. People always ask me, how can you work here? How could you sit here all this time? My faith in God is what keeps me from packing up and leaving town. This is my assignment. It's like a driving force that keeps me having faith in this community. You know, that says, don't let him go yet, Dion. Don't let him go.
If it wasn't for his faith in the risen Jesus, Officer Dion Joseph would have a much easier job. But because of the resurrection, and because he knows he's loved and called to love others, even the difficult ones, he stays. It gives his life meaning and a sense of purpose, knowing that he's helping people that Jesus died and rose again for. Believing in the resurrection doesn't necessarily make life easier, but it does make life better. What difference does Easter make in your life? What difference does it make in your life? What are the difficult things you can do because you know you're a beloved child of God and that Jesus has got your back? You know, when the disciples went out to be the witnesses of the resurrection, they had no idea that 2,000 years later, we'd still be talking about them. They had no idea that 2,000 years later, we would still be looking to their example of what to do. We're here today because they did the difficult stuff. I don't know how Jesus will use the difficult things that we do now to help future generations, but I believe that he will. And that makes them worth doing. Amen. We continue our service with Great is the Lord, the Trinity Choir. It's Kathy Rogotsky is playing violin, Sherry Schaefer playing piano. And let's join our hearts together in prayer. Good and loving Savior, as we face difficult things, help us to remember that you have already defeated all of the bad things in this world, and that nothing can separate us from you and your love, not even death. Give us strength in difficult situations, safety in difficult places, wisdom in difficult decisions, love in difficult relationships, and hope in difficult times. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Healing God, we pray for all of your children who are hurting or in need in any way. We remember today especially Cash Kubik, Vince Hegel, Gladys Kellogg, Stan Maiman, Kiki Connell, Dick Harrington, Mary Jean Zilm, Maggie Schultz, Deb Watkins, Axel Heller, Scott Aspholm, Linda Gerken, Lorna Scrimger, Skip Ward, Noah Mulholland, Bill Wollers Jr., Don Knowlton, and all others. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We lift up to you, Lord, those currently serving in the military and their families, remembering especially Tyler Brockney, Daniel Jacobs, Robson Shanklin, Drew Rattler, Mackenzie Bilhars, Kaylee Fox, Tanner Evans, Hannah Fox, Ben Hauser, Caleb Bilhars, Cameron Kakak, and Kim Hall. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We remember before you, gracious God, those others who are on our hearts and minds as we name them silently before you now. For these and all others for whom we said we would pray, Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Into your hands, O God, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through Jesus Christ our Lord. We all say, Amen. We continue with the offering and the children's offering, whatever goes into the globe. And by the way, it can be kids or those who are young at heart. Anybody of any age can put money in the globe, and it goes to ELCA Good Gifts to buy things for people in need around the world. If you'd like to give a gift online, go to stjohncharlescity.org, click on Digital Simply Giving. Our offering hymn today is We Give Thee But Thine Own, number 686. Let's stand for the offering response.
Thank you.
we pray together the prayer Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And may Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit bless you now and forever. Amen. We sing our ascending hymn number 366, The Strife is O'er, the Battle Won. Done. Go in peace. Share the good news.
Thanks be to God.